Today I've spent whole day doing some refactoring and writing one of my payment methods or payment extensions which I have, and I've decided to refactor this extension using service-oriented approach. So one of my previous videos, we've opened a topic on idea of us refactoring a monolithic Magento 2 extension. And this extension can be refactored in a way that each Magento 2 extension of a feature represent a smaller feature or smaller subset of combined features. And each extension will follow a single responsibility principle. And for example, if I would like to add more features instead of modifying existing Magento 2 extension, I will just introduce another extension which will add functionality to existing set or suite of extensions. As you remember, I've showed an example of one of modules, and this module or set of modules is global payments. I decided to rewrite existing RealX payments integration to follow this approach. So as of now, I spent whole day today rebuilding functionality and trying to find out the best approach and the best place for each feature. So what we have, let me give you some demo and I will explain you what's going on in the code. So first of all, the purpose of me rebuilding this extension is that initially I wrote this extension in 2015, and it's like 4 years I'm updating and adding new features to this extension, RealX Payments extension. And I would say that I used to use some old practices, old development practices. Obviously, I did follow Payment Gateway API, and one of the reasons I've created payment integration in Magento 2 online course for you guys is that I've seen lots of usages of deprecated functionality. That's why I decided to share with you some of my experience, which I've gained during building all these payment integrations. So one of the reasons I've decided to rebuild existing module is that, for example, there is an iframe integration, or it's called hosted payment page integration. And every time you would like to place a payment, place an order, Magento will create a pending payment order, and it will give you some data. And this data can be used to submit a form via iframe, and via this iframe, RealX Payments will show you a payment form. And once you will complete your payment form, you will hit place order and you will be redirected back to Magento, depending on the type of integration, but you will be redirected to Magento. And with this redirect, the second step of payment integration is that it will update status and state and some additional information like payment information or transaction information as a second step of order completion. And order status will be processing instead of pending payment. So this is one of the main issues for merchants, and merchants didn't want, and they don't want to have this kind of experience that order is created with a pending payment status. And as you can see, we have 3 not completed orders. This is basically me clicking to proceed to pay and clicking cancel. This is a very kind of bad experience for customers and for merchants. And for example, if I will click cancel, as you can see, we have a redirect to a shopping cart, because there are some complexity canceling order on the same checkout payments page. That's why I restore quote and then I redirect to shopping cart back. So customer will have to click proceed to checkout and start checkout experience from scratch. So it's kind of negative experience for both merchants and customers. That's one of the reasons I've decided to rebuild extension. However, I decided to do this following service-oriented architecture, and yeah, so I've canceled it, as you've seen. I clicked cancel button, and as you can see, we have new record or new entity in orders grid created and canceled it. So this is kind of a mess for merchants. From other side, what I did, I've re-implemented this whole payments experience. So this is same hosted payment page. However, I'm using different technique. So instead of creating a pending payment order, I decided not to create orders at all. And I will create order only when the payment will be successful. So in this experience, this work in progress. With this experience, you wouldn't find any orders in a Magento grid, orders grid page. You would see only orders created once I will click and payment will be successful. Once I will click pay now and payment will be successful. So this is one of the reasons I did refactor it. However, I wanted to have to apply some latest practices, like development practices, which I follow currently, because I didn't want to rebuild or refactor existing functionality. That's why I started building this functionality from scratch, which allowed me to build a couple of extensions instead of one single extension. I've built a couple of extensions. So what we have here, we have global payments as a repository package, but this is a set of Magento 2 extensions. And for example, HPP checkout UI directory or extension. So this is an extension, just for you to be aware of. This is an installable Magento 2 extension with registration PHP, with module.xml. Later I will add composer JSON file and so on. So this extension is responsible for rendering payment method on checkout payments page, and this is purely for rendering purposes. So we have here a front end with layout and some JavaScript files and some HTML files. I also wanted to get rid of all PHTML templates in this payment integration. This is something I am going to follow starting from Magento 2.3. And so this extension is purely responsible for checkout experience. Once I will add cart storage, I will introduce new module, which I will call HPP Customer Vault module, which will be responsible for rendering cart storage related information on customer account. This would be a responsibility of this module, but this is like for a future. Then I have HPP gateway. This extension is responsible for communicating or for providing integration between global payments. I would say it has a global payments PHP SDK dependency, and this is an entry point or entry point for this SDK, which I use for this global payments integration. So there are two responsibility: providing commands for my hosted payment page integration, and that's it. Like without any configuration, admin panel, admin user experience, it's purely commands and stuff which is required, classes which are required for performing requests and processing responses. I've said on a previous video that in case I would like to introduce a new transaction or new command or new integration, couple of new integrations, let's say cart storage. For cart storage, I'm going to build a separate extension which will not touch HPP gateway extension. And this cart storage extension will be installed upon a request. So if customer or merchant or whoever is going to use this functionality does not need card storage. This extension should not be installed because currently in my monolithic extension, I have all features listed in one extension and 60 or 70% of code or functionality is not used in this extension. So this is purely logically, we can split functionality between smaller extensions and deliver to a production environment smaller pieces of functionality, which are really going to be used by our merchants and customers. So this is the second extension, and third extension which I've implemented for this integration is HTTP API. So this is a set of interfaces and its implementations, and this HTTP API extension will be used by other global payments extensions in order to provide some APIs and to have some glue between other extensions. So for example, a separate extension which I've implemented called HTTP Web API. So this is a set of endpoints for this hosted payment page integration, which has only tests and web api.xml file, which exposes endpoints which I use in HTTP checkout UI extension. So for example, tomorrow I will decide to build a React extension which will render this global payment method. And instead of using HTTP checkout UI extension, I will uninstall it and I will install React based, or I would implement Vue storefront integration. So I wouldn't be holding all extensions on my setup or installation. I would just uninstall checkout UI and install Vue checkout UI or something similar. And lastly, what I wanted to say that, for example, admin UI. So instead of putting admin related functionality or even configuration to one of these modules, there is no a single module which is right for configuration of the extension. That's why I've created admin UI. However, I am going to rename it to HTTP admin UI because there are going to be other features like card storage. So I will build a Vault admin UI extension or order management functionality, like creating invoice or creating or canceling order or and so on. I will build a separate Magento 2 extension which I will install if needed. And yeah, basically that's it. So the idea of this refactoring is to allow granular configuration of this Magento 2 extensions on merchants and production environment. So in case something is not required, this small extension will not be installed. I think it's more flexible compared to monolithic Magento 2 extensions. And yeah, it would be interesting where I will end up with all this functionality and functionalities and refactoring of existing RealX payments extension to be global payments with smaller extensions, which I'm going to distribute for my customers. If you have any questions related to this decoupling or refactoring or how I split functionalities into some extensions, let me know in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe. I would be happy to see your likes below this video because they really motivate me to create daily videos, daily tutorials for you about Magento 2 infrastructure, deployments, automation, and so on. Yes, and I will see you tomorrow with my another tutorial related to Magento 2 development. Almost forgot to share with you great news. In New York, in Manhattan, we're going to host our Magento 2 developer training. This is going to be a two-day training where we will have practical and theoretical exercises, and I will show you how I develop extensions, how you can refactor your extensions and rethink on the practices you currently follow. And after this 2 days training, you will get lots of practical experience which you can apply on your day-to-day work. Check the link below this video and you will find lots of information about details of this Magento 2 developer training, and I will see you May 23rd and 24th, 2019 in New York.